The second letter. The prophecies of Muslim world must come to pass. The sun is to rise in the west. This is occurring due to the return of the seven planets, popularly referred to as Nibiru. The Mahdi also has to appear. It is therefore the 11 descendants of Muhammad who were all contributors of the Quran, and each was either beheaded or poisoned, leaving the 12th to be Muhammad himself in the person of Mahmud Ahmadinejad, who waits for Jesus. Caution regarding all prophecies. For example, in the Bible it is corrupted by translators, warning not to search for Christ in the deserts. Many false Christs would arise, not expecting him to be in everyone's face, abusing all who stumbles his way. Why? Psalms 118:22. The stone which the builders refused is become the headstone of the corner. Or Matthew 21:42, Jesus saith unto them, did ye never read in the scriptures, the stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvellous in our eyes. The next verse points to Iran, Persia, verse 43, where it says, therefore say I unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you and given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof. The women of Iran are the 144,000, Book of Revelation. They must be virgins, meaning they have not known the Christian, Zionist, Satan, imposter, Lord Jesus Christ. Revelation 14:4, quoting, these are they which were not defiled with women, be married, rise and assemble, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb, whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. Muslim women have been suppressed by Muslim men. They long for a tolerant Jesus as the perfect husband, a biblical truth no man is happy with, yet the scriptures predict all must become the wife of Christ. These women cannot emerge from the Eastern Orthodox Church, as they are already familiar with prophecy, yet suppressed by their church leaders, but are representative of the 200 million Orthodox Church. The Russian government support Iran, as Russia is aware of the abomination that makes desolation, are the Zionist Jews dominating Rome, and the head of the Anglican Church of England, headed up by the whore of Revelation, Queen Elizabeth. The Roman Church is Gentile, while the 10 nations of Europe are Israel. The Zionist Israel in Palestine are invented by the Khazar Jews. Predicted as Gog and Magog, which originated in Turkey, then moved into Russia. Scholars point to Ezekiel 38-39 as being Russia, not comprehending the Revelation prophecy, named all seven churches which were in Turkey. The imprint of the devil is within the steps of Paul, who wandered with impunity all over the known world, fearing no Roman soldier. He who killed the followers of Jesus, the Essene. I was Essene. The Queen is behind the plot to destroy the earth by first starting a war with Syria, then Iran, draw in the Russian and Chinese, thus start a nuclear war and kill all life on earth. The idea is for their elect to disappear underground, wait out the nuclear fallout and also the earth flipping its axis from North Pole becoming the South Pole, which they predict will occur in a few hours, sending gigantic tidal waves across the landmass. The giant planet coming from deep space, it an orbiting red dwarf companion of the sun, is antimatter, as are the seven planets orbiting it. None affected by the sun gravity as it is antimatter, like the dwarf, which is locked into the sun via a black hole singularity, and the sun a white hole singularity, in balance via the timeless heavenly realm. The sun a negative and the dwarf a positive, like a hydrogen atom. As I have chosen the Iranian Muslim people and all Muslim women, the 144,000 being my wife, are immortal, spread throughout the nations, therefore protects these nations. The Zionist murdered the Russian royal family. Likewise, Nicholas himself must be rewarded, and he has reincarnated as Vladimir Putin. In reference to why the Zionists plan to destroy the earth, they are the spirits of demons who return to infest the next generation. They believe if they kill all my children, then I, as the Creator, having poured out my soul into all life, which is anything that has DNA within it, then if they were successful, this evil force, Satan, is God. These religious lunatics think they can outsmart the Creator, even though the only weapon I was reborn with was the soul of Yahweh and the memory of my life as Jesus, according to Isaiah 9:6 and 11:1. The temple in Jerusalem, the Jews regard as Solomon's temple, was destroyed in 70 AD by the Jews influencing the Roman Senate. Since the establishing of the Zionist Israel, the Jews wail at its foundation stones, unaware the wall is the remaining stones of the temple to Yahweh, which states in the New Testament via me throwing out the money changers from my father's house. This brings us to why Iran will rebuild the temple to Yahweh. Quoting from Ezra 5:13, but in the first year of Cyrus, the king of Babylon, the same king Cyrus made a decree to build this, the house of God. Then came the same Sheshbazzar and laid the foundation of the house of God, which is in Jerusalem. And since that time, even until now, hath it been in building, and yet it is not finished. Now therefore, if it seem good to the king, let there be search made in the king's treasure house, which is there at Babylon, whether it be so that a decree was made of Cyrus the king to build this house of God at Jerusalem, and let the king send his pleasure to us concerning this matter. We see then the temple was financed by the Persian king, and in 516 BC completed. Then, quoting Ezra 6:1, then Darius the king made a decree, and search was made in the house of the rolls, where the treasures were laid up in Babylon. And there was found at Akhmetha, summer palace in Persia, in the palace that is in the province of the Medes, a roll, and therein was a record thus written. By 153 BC, Rome took Jerusalem and established it as an outpost. The Essene left for Qumran, hiding the scrolls in the caves, later discovered and known as the Dead Sea Scrolls. As the Persians paid for the temple, the Persian kingdom supported the God of Daniel and Ezekiel, Yahweh. It will be rebuilt at Iran's pleasure, and the Jews will have no part in it. As for the mandate, December 21st, 2012, the date is 375 days out. We have already passed that date on December 11th, 2011, when the solar system crossed the Milky Way equator. This caused the strange weather and the Coriolis effect on clouds, oceans, and water turning backwards as it drains down the sink. Rome established the year of the Lord 111 AD and set zero between 1 BC and 1 AD. The zero counted as 365 days. Then, in 1582, October the 4th, the Vatican added 10 days. So we are out 375 days. To prove it, the moon flipped on the 11th of December 2011, and water draining down the sink now turns in the opposite direction. On February 22nd, 2012, the angels will begin to reap the demonized, casting them off the earth by a death in the months to come. Regards, Brian Leonard Golightly, Habsburg Marshall. King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the Lord Jesus Christ, Yahweh.